are not just art for Michelangelo to carve. He can't rewrite the crew of my fury heart. Away on mountaintops in Paris, gold repas, Maria dessert. I'll dance
with my hands above my head. Like Jesus said, I'm gonna dance with my hands above my head. I won't crucify you too. I've become a totally obsessed fanboy, Lady Gaga fanboy. Moi! She's amazing. I just love it. I just got her latest CD. I got the deluxe. And I waited a long time because a lot of the songs I didn't like when I saw the videos, and I thought, oh wow, this album isn't that great. What happened, Lady Gaga? But then I began to watch the videos for Marry the Night. I'm gonna marry the night. La da 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 la dum. I began to watch the videos for that on YouTube, and then she had her Thanksgiving special, and on that special, her performances were outstanding. She's got such a strong voice, and and the songs when she sings them when she's just alone at the piano. They are beautiful songs. And so Marry the Night, and then I saw Marry the Night on the Alan Carr Chatty Man. It's a British television program, which there's a bunch of them available here on YouTube, so I've been watching them on YouTube. And she was on YouTube on Alan Carr's show, and she did Marry the Night, a very slow ballad version. And, boy, that did it, my darlings. That was like, that was, oh dear, I got my other glove in my almond milk. So, I even have my Lady Gaga lip gloss from MAC. Let me just say Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga. And if there's one thing a monster can't have too much of, it's Lady Gaga lip gloss. For all you monsters out there, hello. It's fabulous. And because it's MAC, it tastes really good. It has that vanilla extract. Yeah, and you can wear it anywhere. You can just wear it anywhere. In case somebody wants to lick your pit, there you go. It'll taste extra sweet. Sticky and sweet, just like Madonna. I shall have something to eat, Mother, but I'm talking to the wild about. I'm talking to the planet. The mailman is right across the street. I know who knows what mail I shall get today. Actually, this video is not supposed to be about Lady Gaga, but I'm a bit gaga about Gaga, so I can't help it. But actually, this video is about Thomas Ligotti, because I got this fabulous book in the mail yesterday. The Agonizing Resurrection of Victor Frankenstein. And I read the opening parts. The book is sold out at Centipede Press, the publisher. I found this copy at Amazon.com, and Tom Ligotti himself is selling copies. This is the author's edition, and the way to distinguish it is that the regular editions are numbered in black, and the special author's edition is numbered in red. And Mother, you just had lunch. This is number 14 in red. The regular editions are lettered in black. So that makes it extra special. And last time I checked, there were two more of these editions for sale by Thomas Ligotti himself at Amazon for $125. So you can actually buy it from the author. Pretty bloody cool. Now, I read the opening three scientists portion. The book does have a preface that was written especially for this edition by Thomas Ligotti. So last night I read the first part, Three Scientists. Each section has a wonderful illustration by Harry Holmes Jr. Now, because of my illness, I cough a lot and I lose breath, and my voice gets kind of weak, but I want to read to you the vignette about, it's called The Agonizing Resurrection of Victor Frankenstein, Citizen of Geneva. It's very short. These are vignette prose poems. So it's about two pages. So bear with me. I'm not a great reader, and because of my illness, I shall be coughing, and my voice will be wobbly and staccato-ish. Victor Frankenstein had died on board a ship caught in seas of ice near the North Pole. Subsequently, his body is sent back to his native Switzerland, where, however, there is no one to receive it. Everyone he ever knew has already died before him. His brother William, his friend Henry, his wife Elizabeth, and his father Alphonse Frankenstein, among others, are no more. A minor official in the Genevan Civil Service comes up with a suggestion to donate the corpse, still very well preserved, to the University of Ingolstadt, where the deceased distinguished himself in scientific studies. Hans Hoffmann, a prodigy in comparative anatomy at the University of Ingolstadt, is conducting a series of experiments in his apartment. He has assembled and is quite sure he can vivify a human being from various body parts he has bought or stolen to consummate his project, which to his knowledge has never been attempted and would certainly make him famous. He still needs a human brain, he has heard that the body of a former student at the university at Ingolstadt is preserved in the morgue of the medical school. It seems the man was a brilliant student. This would be the perfect brain, thinks Hans Hoffman. Late one night, he breaks into the morgue and helps himself. Well, says Hans Hoffman, on the spectacular evening when the creature first opens its eyes, aren't you a beauty? This is intended ironically, of course. The creature is quite hideous. What Hans Hoffman now notices is that his creation is gazing around the room as if expecting to see someone who, for the moment, is absent. I know, Mother. The male is here. Oh ho, says the scientist. I can see I'm going to have trouble with you. You'll be begging me one of these days to make you a companion, someone of your own kind. Well, look here, says Hans Hoffman, holding a handful of entrails and part of a woman's face. I've already tried to do it, perhaps a little half-heartedly, I admit. It's not the same making a woman, and I don't have much use for them anyway. Hans Hoffman cannot tell whether or not the creature has understood these words. Nevertheless, it has an extremely desolate expression on its face, just possibly due to a few collapsed muscles. Now the creature is staggering around Hans Hoffman's apartment, inadvertently breaking a number of objects. Finally, it stumbles out the door and into the streets of Ingolstadt. Good riddance, shouts Hans Hoffman. But as the creature wanders into the darkness, searching for a face it remembers from long ago, it is unaware that the only being in the entire universe who could possibly offer him any comfort has already incinerated himself on a furious pyre deep in the icy wasteland of the North Pole. Now, that is astounding. That is just an astounding vignette. It has so much in it, but what shocked me when I first read it last night was that final paragraph, because in that final paragraph, for me, there is an element of exquisite poignancy that I was not expecting. Tom's preface to the book is absolutely brilliant, and he is a dark genius, an amazing dark genius, and this book is, I mean, I want to take my gloves off, because Jared Walters of Centipede Press, he is a genius of book design, and he's the boards, they're covered with velvet. They're velvet, and they feel so wonderful. All of the illustrations are extremely wonderful by Harry L. Morris Jr. You get two book ribbons, one gray and one black. This is quite simply one of the most beautiful and well-designed books I have ever held in my hands. And so I encourage you, I mean, you don't want to pass up the opportunity to have this beautiful edition. If you are a Thomas Ligotti fan, and if you're on the fence, I encourage you to go to Amazon.com and order. I think there's two copies left being sold directly from the author, Thomas Ligotti. And then there are two other editions at a higher price. But once the book is, over time, the book is going to become more and more expensive because it is rare. There were only 500 copies published. So, you know, the paperback, the initial paperback edition is selling for $300 or $400 already. And that's just for the paperback. This, pardon me, is a beautiful hardcover edition. And it's amazing. So, alright, back to Lady Gaga. A little more lip gloss. Oh, the mail's here. I'll go see if I got some cool mail. What's the matter, mother? Are you in pain? You're cold? Yes, it's a cold, chilly, desolate life. We still got snow. I'm bored with the snow. I want it to go away. Shalom, my darlings. I wish you a pleasant day, if possible.